Welcome back to Crypto Fitness. If you like gains, make sure to smash the subscribe button, fucking hit the like, and don't forget, I have a crypto trading secrets course coming out in the upcoming weeks and months. So if you'd like to get on the waitlist, you can get my entire course for free. It will walk you through A to Z, how to leverage trade, how to spot trade. If you're new, if you're a beginner, if you're intermediate, if you're an advanced trader, I promise you will be able to learn something from my course. I talk about advanced techniques, I talk about basic strategies, I talk about sell walls. I also walk you through step-by-step how to set up Bybit, TradingView, Coinbase, and any other exchange or platform, and all the tools you will need to be a successful day trader, long-term trader, swing trader, scalper, any kind of strategy that you are looking out for. So make sure to get on the waitlist for that. You can visit escobarj.com/crypto-trading-secrets to get on the waitlist. I don't know how long it's going to be free for, so make sure that you do it quickly. I may only give it to the first 100 people who get on the waitlist. That being said, today we're going to take a look at Bitcoin, some news, Ethereum, and Cardano. So let's go ahead and jump into the charts. Ethereum. You can see that we have a very similar pattern to what Bitcoin is doing, although it is looking a little bit more bullish than Bitcoin. You can see the money flow wave is actually staying relatively strong here. It is flattening out, and which is good news. Obviously, we've got a couple green dots here. We've got a double green dot, right? So we've got some duals down here, which is good. And it looks like we are going curving to the upside a little bit. We are holding the 50-day or the 100-day moving average. We did come down and touch the 200-day moving average for Ethereum. And it looks like we are holding the 100-day and trying to break past the 50-day moving average as well and 20-day moving average also. So hopefully we get that. If Bitcoin breaks out, obviously Ethereum is going to break out. You want to make sure you pay attention to that. And we do have some strong numbers here on Ethereum as far as the technical analysis and as far as market cipher goes. On the DBSI, we've got a 16 on the daily time frame here, which is strong. A 16 over a negative 5, that's bullish. The previous candle is a 13 and the previous candle from that is a 10. So that is relatively bullish for Ethereum. Those are pretty good numbers. You can see they're increasing for the bull, so that's good news. If we go down to the 12-hour chart, you can see the same type of thing, a 16, a 17 over negative 5, a 4, a 2, and now a 9. So we're slowing down, and now it looks like we are speeding up a little bit. You can see the money flow wave has come down, almost touched the zero line, and it's now flattening out. The RSI is flattening out. We've got these, we have a Cerberus here. That's what CryptoFace likes to call this. This triple green dot here calls it a Cerberus. And we have another green dot here, and it looks like it's coming up, and it looks like it's not slowing down. However, obviously, we have to make sure we watch Bitcoin in this scenario. Now, we are in I did chart a neckline here. You can see that this is a inverse head and shoulders for Ethereum. So if we can break this point, the target out of this, if Bitcoin breaks out, the target for Ethereum would actually be all the way up here at about 3990. So we'll call it 4,000 for Ethereum. So that would create a lower high from the previous all-time high. And you can see there's a couple key Fibonacci areas. There's the 1618 at around $3,300 for Ethereum. And there's also the 2618 at $4,088. And then obviously the target is approximately $4,000 as well. So it's obviously will be good to take profits along the way if we break to the upside. If we zoom down to the 6-hour chart. We're thick in the red on the 6-hour chart. It looks like the money flow is coming to the upside. We do have the momentum oscillators coming to the upside. It looks like it could be flattening out, slowing down here. The RSI is actually headed to the downside, so we are getting rejection. It looks like RSIs are oversold. They are purple and green, which means oversold. So that is another bullish indicator. So this is looking relatively bullish. We do have an 8 on the DBSI for Ethereum on the 6-hour chart, so not as strong as we'd like to see, but obviously just pay attention to what Bitcoin is doing, and you can pretty much predict what Ethereum is going to do. However, Ethereum has actually been pumping harder, so when Bitcoin is in the green, Ethereum has actually been performing better than Bitcoin. And same with a few other altcoins as well. So if we go to the 4-hour chart, take a look at the DBSI there. We are coming up in the 4-hour chart. We have peaked our head over the zero line into the green money flow, so that is good news. However, on the DBSI, we're getting a 9 over a 0 on the DBSI for the bears. So it looks like we did get rejected, and we are coming down. Looks like the momentum oscillator is coming to the downside as well. Also, the VWAP is also coming to the downside. So hopefully, we just come back down here and just consolidate in this area before blasting off. Obviously, just watch Bitcoin. Just if whatever Bitcoin does is what Ethereum is going to do. So just make sure that you are watching both assets. Down to the 1-hour chart, if we go a little bit more to the smaller time frames, we do have some bearish DBSI numbers here. We've got 16, 15, 20, 21, 18, and now at 11. So it looks like it could be slowing down a little bit, but these are pretty strong numbers to the downside. We have tested the bottom of the EMA ribbon on the 1-hour chart, and we are, looks like just maybe coming back down for consolidation before maybe hopefully testing this top resistance at about $2,700 or $2,800. If we can get a clean break, that's going to be amazing. We are coming to the downside on the momentum oscillator. Money flow is coming to the downside. RSI is already to the downside, but it is flattening out here. So hopefully we can get another leg to the upside, maybe get another little rally here. The RSIs are overbought, so they are red and purple, which means overbought. They have crossed back here. But again, you just got to make sure that we're watching Bitcoin and what Bitcoin does, the whole rest of the crypto market is going to do. So that is Ethereum in a nutshell. And obviously, this is going to hopefully we can get a relief rally and see some of these higher price action here in the short term. Now, longer term, it's looking like Bitcoin is going to be in a cool-off period. We talked about Wyckoff distribution. We're either in the phase E of the Wyckoff distribution or phase A of the Wyckoff accumulation period. And the accumulation period can take anywhere from a few weeks to a few months to up to a year. So, I mean, if you're trying to accumulate, that's great news. If you are a hodler, if you are just a FOMO trader, then obviously that's bad news for you. But this could be a great opportunity to accumulate more Bitcoin, more cryptocurrency in general. So that is an update for Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Cardano. And it's looking relatively bullish. We are testing the upper trend lines of Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Cardano. And if Bitcoin can break out here, it's going to be looking good. We are at the top trend line. If we can break out of it, now if we test the bottom, if we fail, if we get rejected, if we test the bottom of Bitcoin's support, it looks like we are at the apex of the triangle. So I don't think that if we don't break past this resistance for Bitcoin, I think we're in for a bloodbath down to the 20,000s. Because we are already at the apex of the triangle, the symmetrical triangle, which would mean that everything else is going to, the whole crypto space is going to be a bloodbath in the upcoming days. Good buying opportunities, but if you're already in positions, it's going to hurt for a little while before going to the upside. If you want to trade with leverage, you can visit Bybit. And don't forget that I have a crypto trading secrets course that's going to be coming out in the upcoming weeks. I'm working on it right now. I'm a solopreneur, so it's taking me some time. But it's going to walk you through step by step, A to Z, how to set up leverage trading, how to trade profitably with leverage, also how to spot trade, how to swing trade to determine what kind of trader you are. It's going to walk you through everything that the top crypto experts and traders are using and some of the most advanced cutting edge strategies they're using to gain an edge in this market. Whether the market's going up or down, my course will teach you how to maximize your profits, know when to enter and exit trades, as well as a lot of other advanced techniques that you will learn to become the most profitable trader you can do so you don't lose money and don't lose your crypto. So that being said, if you'd like to make a donation, you can donate any amount of money or crypto. If you'd like to support my work and support me making more content for you and getting out content faster to you, if you'd like to support the channel, you can donate any amount of money or crypto you feel is equal to the value of the information in this video or in my other videos or my course as well. As you know, I'm getting away my course for free. So if you'd like to support the channel, my Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Cardano addresses are down in the description. And lastly, if you like making gains in your body, mind, and portfolio, make sure to smash the subscribe button, hit the like, and share this with your friends and family. That being said, I will see you in the next video. Take care.